Jack Waterford was living in a shared household in Canberra back in the early 70s with a group of activists. Then the phone bill came in and no one could afford it, so Jack went out to get a job. He walked down the road and knocked on the door of the Canberra Times, and Jack was given a job as a copy boy.
Jack Waterford was the outstanding servant of the Canberra Times in the second half of the 20th century. It is only a slight exaggeration to state that he taught Australian journalists how to use national freedom of information laws introduced in the 1970s. For most journalists, the laws were too complex, too slow, and too legalistic. Waterford persisted and proved they could be used to uncover important stories. They are now a routine part of the journalist toolkit.
And even now, I would insist that one of the good results of FOI, in spite of the disincentives in fees, was the fact that it actually did change a lot of the attitude of public servants. There's a lot more material which is now generally accessible without asking many questions. I'm now finding that to some extent you have to train a new generation of public servants that this is not some grace or favour operation, but is a matter of right. So I've been starting to take a few cases to court again just to prove that the Act has some teeth, even if it's not as strong as I would like.
In a 43-year career with the Canberra Times, Waterford started as a copy boy and became editor-in-chief, gathering accolades, including the Australian Journalist of the Year Award, in 1985.
I think he's been tremendously significant, especially in Canberra, and very much the backbone of the Canberra Times over many years. His identification with the local community, his ability to get across such a wide range of subjects. When I was at the Canberra Times, Jack could do his day's work and then knock off an editorial very quickly on almost anything. He always did joke that he didn't have time to write short, so he wasn't a tight writer. His pieces were quite extensive, but fortunately in those days, we usually had plenty of space.